안녕, 친구.
Today we're exploring Seafood Street on the north side of Jeju Island. Enjoy the sea breezes and passing boats while walking on the jetty lined with tetrapods.
In just a bit, we're going to be going to Hue Street, where they have fresh seafood.
The seafood street happens to be right across from my hotel. It leads directly into the jetty. All these buildings contain restaurants, and they're waiting for you. The entrance is marked with a silver gate, which reads at the top, 서부도 명품 횟집 거리. The English translation is West Wharf Premium Sashimi Restaurant Street.
I haven't decided yet which restaurant to eat at. We'll find out together. Let's take a look at the menus.
Seats are being set out as the evening approaches. Between these two vehicular paths, there are picnic tables. 아침 식사 됩니다. That means they do breakfast.
It could be a challenge when you're traveling alone and eating seafood in Busan and Jeju-do.
The pricing and portion are often made for two servings or more. Also in the situation with Korean barbecue.
우정 횟집. So this restaurant serves 전복죽?
Yeah, yeah. 골고루 다 있으니까 중국말도 있고 영어도 있고 한국말도 있고 다 있습니다. 사시미 해가지고 사시미도 조금 해가지고 골고루 먹는 거?
네.
사모님 잠깐만. 한치 한 마리, 우럭 한 마리, 매운 탕까지 해서 7만 원.
I'm feeling adventurous. Let's give this restaurant a shot. Instead of reading reviews, we'll form an opinion firsthand from a clean slate. Just like what they did in the old, old days. We are blessed with a scenic view of a parking lot.
The restaurant next door also has a back dining area outdoors.
Okay, while we're waiting for the food, let me show you a closer look of the dock. All right, we're gift wrapping the table.
As an appetizer, we are given juk, haemuchim, raw garlic and raw pepper, a glass for beer and a shot glass for soju. Looks like green tea ice cream, but it is a dab of wasabi paste. Enough for the three of me.
This here is chojang and ganjang, soy sauce, and the service bell. You might think chopsticks that come out of paper must be wood, but no, metal chopsticks were inside. 감사합니다. You have water? We'll use this beer cup. Let's try a spoonful of this juk.
It contains slices of scallion as well as carrot. Juk is one of those things I grew up eating when I was sick. If you've never had rice porridge before, the texture is very soft. It breaks apart easily. Whatever other ingredients you add into your juk, that will create more texture and flavor. In this case, we have some crunchiness from the raw scallion. It's a little salty as well.
Ooh, is this squid?
Only one way to find out. Oh, I just got a beauty mark. That's squid. Rubbery. You have to chew about 15 more times compared to the rice porridge.
Oh, and look closely. We have sprinkles of sesame seeds.
Oh, it's spicy.
Wow, that is fun.
전복도 드린 거야. 전복. 한치, 고등어, 갈치, 문어, 멍게.
멍게, 감사합니다. 네.
Will all this fit in my stomach? Before taking a bite, let us take a close look at the abalone, cutlass fish, octopus, mackerel, cuttlefish, crab, and I believe this one is pollock.
You dip it with the sauces, but I like to have my fish plain.
I don't even know where to begin.
I'm competing with the fly, it keeps landing on my food.
Oh, the shiny, mesmerizing.
The interior is soft, but then that exterior is a bit tough to bite on.
Look at the black veins.
That one has more of a muted crunch sound.
I have to say it's far from buttery.
Raw mackerel. Typically, I have it cooked. The skin goes from a gray-blue to a light silver. Compared to the pollock we just had,
the interior is not as soft, but the exterior is also not as tough.
On to the octopus. Our slices contain tentacles.
The outer layer was jiggly. There's more flavor in that octopus compared to the slices of fish we had.
The bright orange side dish reminds me of ripe persimmon, but it is crab.
Whoa, that one's bitter. A little salty as well. But it's also the most slippery and easiest to chew. It has a lingering flavor on your tongue.
The specks on the cuttlefish pulsate. Yo, my trypophobia is triggered. Who's with me?
Ooh. Oh, the tentacles are moving on that one. You know when a dog is licking you and there's like some sort of friction feeling on your skin? When the squid's tentacles touch your tongue, it has that sort of friction feeling.
We dig into the abalone.
The abalone is the toughest to bite on. That one for sure has a muted crunch.
The salad contains lettuce, carrot, and shredded cabbage.
It's a sweet dressing.
Nothing fancy, but veggies are always welcome.
Let's try the seasoned cucumber.
In terms of experience, my favorite is a cuttlefish.
You might be wondering, are these clear noodles edible? Let me show you. Actually, wow, it's like tangled hair. They're kelp noodles.
My least favorite is the crab, which looks like an overly ripe persimmon. In terms of glamour, the cutlass fish wins the beauty pageant. So flashy, so shiny. Actually, I take that back. The cuttlefish is more flashy.
This time, let's dip the slices into the sauce. I'll take this. How do you like your hot dogs? Do you like to put ketchup on it? Oops, I just dropped my garlic. Do you like to put relish on it? So when you eat raw fish, maybe you might like it plain. I like my hot dogs plain, to be honest. If you like spicy, then you have your slices with some of wasabi. Be mindful when you eat, because every so often, you might have a bone. That's another one.
The abalone skin reminds me of very dry dirt.
Ah, 밥 무슨 밥이요?
나한테 식사 드려야 될 거 아니야? 밥 먹어야 되잖아. 탕하고.
아, 또 뭐 나와요? 음식이요? The sliced seafood was part one, and now we're on to part two.
Except for the kimchi, the second set of dishes are cooked. It's shaped like a surfboard, but cut in half.
When you get tigim at street food stalls, at traditional Korean markets, typically they'll have sweet potato inside or kabocha, and even shrimp. Upon further inspection, I have concluded it is starchy in the inside, and it is a sweet potato.
This fish is so skinny, it makes knives jealous. Thick bits of scallion float on our stew. We have our radish and chunks of fish. Hey, that rhymes.
I really get that taste of the fish meat. Alright, this fish is called jetty. Look at those extroverted bones. Quite easy to pick out, because they're so big. It nearly has the texture of chicken breast.
Specks of seaweed embellish the rice. Time to excavate.
That one tastes a bit earthy. It's not as soft as a rice porridge, but it's certainly softer than most of the fish slices we've had.
Let's try another fried good here.
Ooh, that's crispy. But what's in the inside? Oh, it looks like fish. Let's try a chunkier piece and inspect the interior. Oh, this is definitely fish in there.
Let's try the napa cabbage kimchi.
It's a pretty light kimchi. I like that it's not too sweet, but definitely it is spicy. Ooh. But it's not like my ears are ringing just yet.
Let's take a moment and admire the gradient. From a dark gray to light gray to beige, with golden shine from head to tail.
It has like beef jerky texture.
This one has a lot of thin bones, so you need to be mindful. Don't be drunk and trying to be picking these out. It'll definitely be a challenge.
Dinner has concluded. Allow me to show you other options. This restaurant has been covered by many Korean bloggers on Naver. You could think of Naver as the Korean Google. Wowza, the options.
Here's a restaurant called Daejin. During the day, this is empty and the chairs are stacked. But because it is evening, they set up the tables outside. To the left, we have concrete tetrapods. And the sun is setting.
Haegeumgang, this restaurant bookends a seafood street.
Here's a warning about the tetrapods. It is easy to get in, but it is hard to get out of. I know these extended family of concrete tetrapods look like a playground. It looks like so much fun, but you gotta be cautious.
I myself am tempted to go on the tetrapod, sit down, have a little snack, maybe like almonds.
But what is tempting is not always in your best interest, is it now? You rebel you.
It has cooled down. Earlier this afternoon, I was sweating buckets.
The clouds tuck the sun in for bedtime. As the sun says farewell, the moon says hello. fisherman from his left, fisherman from behind, fisherman from his right.
It's now past 8 p.m. It's more lively at nighttime, as you can see.
We are near the airport, thus the frequent plane sightings.
Hope you guys enjoyed eating hui with me. I'm actually not really big on seafood, but I wanted to show you guys a place you can check out while you visit Jeju-do.
Remember to subscribe and hit that notification bell. For food and travel outside of Korea, check out my other channel, Miss Mina. Believe it or not, my new YouTube channel is finally out, ASMR Bedtime with Miss Mina. The link is in the description box.
안녕!
It gives you this like, weird feeling, and I kind of like that. I dig it. This street has been operating since 1965.
I don't know why, but I get so happy to see clothes being sun-dried.
Is it just me, or do you also find the cracks on the tetrapods to be just kind of sexy?
When you walk here, there's a bunch of these bugs that are quick.